Welcome back. Score after halftime, 43-28 for your CNFX X women. Leah Colby for three. Good. You're going to be looking to have a better start in the third quarter than they did. Ashley Stevens bringing up the ball, swinging the ball around. You've been seeing some good ball movement from the CNFX X women. Ashley with a nice drive. Cheap. Almost got the trap there by Kamisha McKenzie. UMB swinging the ball around. Looking like they're moving with a bit more urgency this quarter. Hopefully. Trying to start a run of their own. Colburn attacking the rim, getting the foul. She's currently at the line, about to shoot two. And she misses on her first attempt. No good on the second either. Kirsten Jones with the rebound. Tori Anderson starting up the offense, swinging the ball around to the hot hand, Cheryl Chisholm. Next woman finally get penetration. Kick out to Kirsten Jones, and that's a nice shot. She's been very consistent with that shot this season. Very threatening from out there. Almost a steal by Cheryl Chisholm. Nice trap, killing some time off the clock. Nice block. Kamisha McKenzie with it. Saving 2 points. So CNFX is matching UNB's intensity to start the third. Sharp with a jumper, no good. Rebounded by Sheehan. Kamisha McKenzie for two. Good. And then applies the pressure on the defensive end. What hustle we've been seeing from Kamisha today. Nice steal, Kirsten Jones, led by great defense from Rebecca Sheehan. Tori pushing up the ball as she usually does. Finds the hot hand. Oh, no good this time. I'm sure UMB's worried about that 3-point jump shot. Colburn gets fouled. Not a very smart foul by Sheehan. Coach Skinner's not too happy about that one. Got some subs coming in, Denisha Young and Jocelyn Moore. Misha's been playing all right so far. Can't leave Emma Russell for three. Can't really be leaving people open. Good hustle to almost try to get the rebound. Kamisha McKenzie bringing up the ball, calling the offense. Very nice passing by the X-Women. Denisha Young at the line. This X Women Basketball webcast is brought to you by the X Varsity Club. Join the team behind the teams. The X Varsity Club is a fundraiser entitled for the CNFX athletic program. Your financial support is essential to our success and maintaining the tradition of excellence. Visit www.goxgo.ca to learn more about the X Varsity Club or join the club today. And Denisha Young with hitting one of her two free throws. good on the second one. And then you see the ex-women applying the pressure, as they always do. Good defense by Commissioner Kenzie. UMB showing some good poise, some good passing. Fortunately, Emma Russell couldn't hit the shot, but that was a fairly good offensive possession. However, on the defensive end, they're letting too many easy baskets, too many easy penetrations. I'm sure Jeff Speedy, head coach of the UMB Varsity Reds, is not too thrilled about that. Jocelyn Moore with the attack, no good. Rebounded by Foster. And UMB's pushing the ball up the court, trying to get back momentum. Colburn with three. Not really hitting much of her shots this half. But she hustles down and gets the and one bucket. Hoping her team responds. And Rebecca Sheehan, Cheryl Chisholm, my apologies, back in the game. Cheryl Chisholm was subbed out. Little miscommunication there. Again, some nice swings. And UMB again, a long penetration. St. Francis Xavier is really playing like they would like to win, like they were the number one team. Technical foul goes to Amanda Sharp. I believe it's for unsportsmanlike conduct. Cheryl Chisholm at the free throw line. Good on the first. Good again on the second. So St. FX does good with their technical free throw. And now shooting her foul shots. And she hits both. That's a very big turnaround. 4 points and the ball back. Jeff Speedy's not too happy about that. Anisha Young in the post, where she's always a threat, and she misses. Colburn with the rebound. Coach Skin is yelling at his team, trying to get them to play some defense. And they leave Fowler open for three. Tori Anderson trying to change the pace on the offensive end. Justin Moore with the ball. Again, X-Women with some good offense, swinging the ball around, trying to get the best shot possible. Tori Anderson, good from the mid-range spot. Colburn with some penetration. Referee said Denisha Young did not get there on time. And that's three fouls on Denisha Young. About to get subbed off for Kirsten Jones. Can't really complain about that sub if I have to tell you. Kirsten for Denisha. That's a good trade-off. Something the X-Women, that really helps the X-Women. On the other side, Colburn hitting her first and hitting the second. Bringing the score to 57-38 for the X-Women. Cheryl Chisholm, no good. However, the rebound goes to Spencer Lockhart. UMB is not playing very aggressive down in the post. It's not very common for the number one team in the AUS right now. Again, penetration and another offensive rebound to Kristen Jones. Brought out to Ashley Steven, and she hits the mid-range jump shot. Second chance points. Their hustle on that end is the reason why there's a 21-point lead. Jumper by Shime, sorry. Rebounded by Kirsten Jones. Almost with the turnover, but sees Jocelyn Moore for the mid-range jump shot. Ooh, a little bit too aggressive by Spencer Lockhart. She gets charged with the foul. But you gotta admire her her physicality. That's what she's on the court to do. Just be a body out there, be a presence. And she's letting her presence be felt. However, UNB's at the line. So, not a very good trade-off, especially that they're in the bonus. Giving Colburn another point off the free throw line. And she goes 1-for-2. However, they do not hold the offensive rebound. Jocelyn Moore coming, bringing up the offense. Setting up their offense, which has been so effective today against the Varsity Reds. Screen for, and she hits another one. The net must seem like the ocean right now. She can't miss. She's not missing anything. Travel by Melissa Foster, and another turnover for the Reds.
Yes, you're out.
Cheryl being subbed off, being hailed by her teammates for her play. And I don't blame them. Ashley Steven coming off the screen by Kirsten Jones. Kicking it to Kamisha McKenzie, sorry. Back to Ashley, who attacks. And a 360 finish. Everything going CNFX's way today. And great hustle back on defense. That was a very nice move by Emma Russell. Very good footwork. To give her the 2 points. However, they do not get back on defense. That's been their problem all day. Leaving Kristen Jones open. She'll hit that all day. And a three. Nice. Laura Fowler with a three. Again, setting up the offense, which has been so effective for the X-Women today. And they go back to Kirsten Jones, who scores again. I'm not sure what the points in the paint is right now, but I'm pretty sure it's very favorable for the X-Women, who've just been dominating in the paint. And a turnover. Another turnover by Fowler. Going to Jocelyn Moore, sorry. Ashley Steven with the mid-range jump shot, and it's good. Like I said, everything is going their way today. And they've just been playing like... Well, playoffs is coming soon, so they are playing, hoping to stamp themselves into a way to nationals, and they know that this is the team they have to go through. CNFX with a commanding lead, 69-44. Kristen Jones, good on her first. And good on her second. With about 2 minutes left in the third quarter, CNFX sits on a comfortable lead, but still applies the pressure, knowing they cannot let up. Good defense by Tori Anderson. Colburn trying to get something going here and nearly gets in. Nearly. Tamisha McKenzie with the rebound. And Tori Anderson is out on the break. 3-on-1. Let's see what they do with it. Spencer Lockhart with the jump shot. No good, but rebounded by Tori. Right back out to Cheryl Chisholm, who hits another three. She's just on fire. The Varsity Reds have no answer for her right now. Not a very smart foul by Denisha Young, who already had three. Just got subbed in. But back to Cheryl Chisholm. UNB definitely has to find her. There's no way she can be left open this long. She just keeps knocking down threes. And Coach Jeff Speedy just does not know what to do. This is not like the UNB Varsity Reds. Missing free throws. Spencer Lockhart with the rebound. With a kick. Nice passing again by the ex-women. Tamisha McKenzie to Denisha Young, who gets fouled. Fouled by Melissa Foster. Only her first. The ex-women basketball and CNFX Athletic would like to thank our major sponsors for their continued support. Keith, Pepsi, Bell Aligned, the Virgin Grand Credit Union, Subway, Central Home Improvement, the Chronicle Herald, and Tim Hortons. With a solid 30-point lead, Tori Anderson applying pressure. Just smothering Corby. Justin Moore also playing some good defense. Oh, not a very good foul by Kamisha McKenzie. Giving Russell two free throw shots. In the bonus, you have to discipline yourself not to let the opponent get stop clock points. She did not. And again, missing two free throws, which is just killing the Varsity Reds. And this one, Kirsten Jones with a turnover. Good defense played by Melissa Foster, not allowing anything. About 15 seconds to go. Coach Matchkin subs off Kirsten Jones for Spencer Lockhart, hoping that she does not get any more silly fouls. Cheryl Chisholm playing some good defense on Colburn. Very good defense, making her turn over the ball. And that's the end of the third. Score 75-45. For your ex-women. And this ex-women basketball webcast is coming to you live on SSN Canada. the Streaming Sports Network. Visit the Streaming Sports Network at www.ssncanada.ca. SSN, your sports, anywhere and anytime.
Back here at the Oland Center to start this final quarter of play. The score is 75-45 for the X-Women. Ashley Steven has the ball at top. Takes it off a high ball screen from Kirsten Jones, but she's called for a moving screen. She's got her arms up a little too high on the defender. So it'll be UNB ball. Coming back down to try to erase some of this 30-point deficit that they've dug themselves into in 10 minutes. See how well they do at that. Corby with the ball, drives middle. Russell in down low for Foster. She puts up a shot, rims out. Kamisha McKenzie with the rebound. Moore bring the ball up the floor. Sheehan on the wing. Back around to McKenzie on the other side. Inside for Jones, who was triple teamed and got hacked by number 14, who looks like she took a shot to the face, so that kind of sucks. It's Melissa Foster's second foul. It'll be X-Woman ball to pass it in. And the ref here is warning the UNB assistant coach. I'm going to guess that's Dan Godgen. I'm not sure if I said his name right, but... Oh, nope. He teed up the assistant coach here, so... Ashley Steven will be at the line to shoot two free foul shots, and then they'll get the ball after those shots are done. I'm not sure what he said, but if I could hear him, I would tell everyone watching. It's probably pretty funny. Ashley Steven makes both for foul shots. So it'll be X-Women basketball at half-court line. Jocelyn Moore will pass it in. Ashley Steven with the ball on the wing. It's a high ball screen from Jones, who continues right-hand layup and is hacked by Russell. So she'll go back to the line and shoot two more foul shots. Tomorrow, the X-Women will be playing the UPEI Panthers. It's a 2 o'clock afternoon game, local time here, so kind of an early game. The farther west out you go in the country, anyone watching from out west. Both foul shots are good for Steven. Corby will bring the ball up the floor. Ashley Steven, we called on a foul here. She's holding number 15. Claire Colburn couldn't make the cut that she wanted to make, so. And this ref, not sure his name, is just chucking out technical fouls left, right, and center as Skin was just pegged for one. I think he was just yelling at Ashley Steven. But they teed up Skin anyways. Either way, Corby's at the line. She hit her first shot, and that was actually Ashley Stevens' fourth foul. So she'll have to watch where she puts her hands for the rest of the game. Both foul shots were made off a technical foul by Corby. So it'll be UNB ball at half. Russell to pass it in. Corby with the ball, bringing it up the floor against Jocelyn Moore. Corby passes it off to Fowler. Corby for three. Nails it. That was a nice shot. Just kind of just off the three-point line there. Kind of a deep shot. Just knocked it down. Sheehan inside for Jones, who kicks it out to Steven. Kamisha McKenzie driving right. Easy layup. No defense on that. Oh. Jocelyn Moore with the steal. And left-handed layup. That looked like was blocked pretty cleanly. But Emma Russell will be called on the foul. Jocelyn Moore will be at the line for two. Knocks down her first one. Scores 82-50 for the X-Women. Very high scoring game here again tonight. Partially due to Cheryl Chisholm, who probably has close to 30 points. It's unreal. Jocelyn Moore made her second foul shot, and Anderson subs her off. UNB ball coming in the baseline. And Fowler brings it up the floor against tough Anderson defense. Holstein with the shot with a long two, rimmed out. Fowler with the rebound, puts it in. Foster with the rebound for easy two. McKenzie on the wing, back up to Jones, who drives left. Easy layup. Team's got to realize that Kirsten Jones is a left-handed player. They don't want her to score. They need to force her right, so people can't figure that one out. Easy two for Kaminsky on a little drop pass layup there. Jones on the wing. Swings up the top for Lockhart. Across to McKenzie. Back across to Chisholm, who drives left. Easy layup. The story of the last couple of baskets here. Easy layups for the X-Women. Fowler bring the ball up the floor to Holstein on the wing. Looks inside for Kaminsky. Tries to move on Jones, but couldn't move her. Holstein kicks it out. Foster with the right-handed drive layup. She was hacked. Went in. She'll shoot one foul shot. Kirsten Jones with the foul. Coach Speedy calls timeout for the UNB Varsity Reds. 7 minutes left in the game. X-Women are up by 31 points. So we're kind of seeing a repeat of the last time UNB was here. UNB is ranked 7th in the country and 2nd, 1st in AUS. 1st in the AUS. And every time they come to the Oland Center, they get smacked around by the X-Women. So it's kind of interesting. I don't know if it's in their head or if they can't travel the whole 5-hour bus trip that it is to get here, but they always usually come out pretty flat, so sucks for them, to say the least. And X-Women just coming out just blazing tonight. Every shot they're taking with confidence, and they are knocking down very high percentage of them. So they had a very good week of practice, and it's carrying over to the first game of their doubleheader here this weekend in Antigonish. So like I said earlier, UPEI will be here. They are ranked, well, they're last in the AUS with no wins yet this season. So hopefully the X-Women can pull out their last win, the last home game with a win here tomorrow afternoon. Foul shots missed by Foster, but rebounded by Colburn. Kinsey with the ball on the wing. Looks inside for Young. Squares up. Goes to work. Easy two. Kaminsky can't guard that. She's a little too skinny. Holstein on the wing. Drive middle. Colburn at the top of the ball. Drives right. Loose ball on the floor. Good hustle by Chisholm to get that ball. Great job. Anderson bringing the ball up the floor. Chisholm fixing her face mask. And Kamisha McKenzie just rejected by the long arms of Samantha Kaminsky. Amanda Sharp in for the game for UNB along with Leah Corby. Excellent ball on the baseline. Tori Anderson up top for McKenzie. She'll Chisholm drive baseline. She's hacked by Holstein and she'll be shooting two. Ashley Steven in the game for Lockhart. Foul shots rattled in by Chisholm. I don't know how many points she has, but she has 32. 33. It's wild. Corby bring the ball up the floor. Passes it to the top to Sharp. Passes it inside for Holstein. Drop step middle, but rimmed out. Ashley Steven with the rebound. Michelle Chisholm on the wing with the ball. Looks in for Young, who skips it over to Anderson. Shoots a three, but is a little off. Holstein with the rebound, brings the ball up. Corby with the ball, driving middle. Kaminsky down low for Sharp. Drives left. Gets her left-handed layup to go. Scores 91-60. 5.5 minutes left in the game. Chisholm with the ball. Steven up top, inside to Young. Her layup is rims out. Corby brings the ball up the left-hand side of the floor. Passes it up to number 10. Shoots a little runner, but rims out. Amanda Sharp with the rebound. Gets batted around by the X-Women off of their fingertips, so it remains UNB ball. Coming in the game is number 8, Danielle Skime. Sorry if I butcher that last name. And Sheehan in for McKenzie for the X-Women. Cheryl Chisholm with a great steal there, just off the inbound. Pass it up to Anderson. Down to Sheehan, who drives baseline. Pushed around a bit, but makes the left-handed layup go. Corby bring the ball up the floor. Drives right. Kaminsky at the top. Sharp down low. Is hacked and the shot falls. So she'll get one foul shot. That'll be Denisha Young's fifth foul, so she'll have to sit out the rest of the game. And Coach Skin will take his 30-second mini timeout to make a sub in for Young. Kirsten Jones will come into the game for Denisha Young. And the score here is 93-62 for the X-Women. We might see a 100-point game here. It's definitely doable with 5 minutes left in the game still. I don't believe that the X-Women have made 100 points in a game yet this year. It's always a fun challenge. Anderson up the floor to Sheehan. Looks inside for Jones. Back up to Sheehan. Around for Chisholm. Jones on the baseline. Passes into Steven, who goes to work. an attack by Emma Russell. Steven will go to the line and shoot two. That is Emma Russell's fourth foul. Ashley Stevens' first foul shot's good. And her second one's short. Sharp with the rebound. Corby bring the ball up the floor on the right-hand side. Corby doing a little ball handling skills. Tries to get her layup drop, but doesn't. Jones with the rebound, and Anderson bring the ball up the floor. Pushes up to Sheehan. Across to Chisholm, who drives right-hand baseline. Loses control a little bit. Gains it back. Sheehan at the top. Drives left. And misses a foul shot, but retaliates with a hack on Emma Russell. So she'll be going to the line, the other end, and shoot bonus. And that's Sheehan's fifth foul, so Skin will take his 30-second timeout to make a sub for her. Fouls have always been trouble for the X-Women this season. They have been really prone to getting two fouls early on. Most of the time it was their bigs early on in the game. And like I said before, it's kind of Skin's coaching mentality that once you get two early fouls in the first half that he benches you the rest of the game so that you don't pick up a third one so that you can play more. But we don't see many people fouling out close to the end of the game like this. They usually figure out how to stop fouling, but tonight's an exception. Emma Russell's first foul shot goes down. Second one drops as well. And she'll be subbed off, and into the game is Melissa Foster for the Varsity Reds. Tori Anderson, nope. Ashley Steven bringing the ball up the floor. Drives middle off the high ball screen by Jones. Kamisha McKenzie, baseline drive. Called for an offensive foul. Great work there by Danielle Skime, number 8, to step in, take the body of Kamisha McKenzie and draw that foul. Since that was an offensive foul, they won't shoot any bonus shots. But Leah Corby will bring the ball up the floor for the Varsity Reds. Ashley Steven with the rebound. Cheryl Chisholm inside for Jones, going to work. Amanda Sharp did a really good job there, forcing Kristen Jones to do a drop step with her right hand and shoot with her right hand, because Kristen Jones is left-handed, so she cut off the middle drop step there. It's good defense. She knew Kristen Jones' trick there. See Corby bringing the ball to the floor. Passes it up to Claire Colburn, who drives middle and misses that foul shot. Good attempt. She might have been hit. Kind of looked a little rough. Tori Anderson bringing the ball to the floor. 3 minutes left in the game. X-Men went up by 30. Cheryl Chisholm down low for Kirsten Jones, who misses her shot. Kind of looked like she might have been hacked there, but number 8 bringing the ball up the floor. Pull up long 2. No good. Tori Anderson with the rebound. She looks to push the ball down the floor. Kirsten Jones itching to take that 3. Does it. Ashley Steven on the wing with the ball. Swings it to Chisholm. Over to Anderson. Down low to Jones. Baseline jumper. Almost rolled in. Not quite. Foster with the rebound. Corby bringing the ball up the floor. Easy pass inside for Sharp. And even easier layup. Anderson with the ball at top. baseline drive by Chisholm. She's hacked by number 15, Claire Colburn. So Cheryl will be at the line for two. That's Colburn's third foul. Into the game for UNB, number 11, number 5, and number 10. And for the X-Women, rookies Kylie DeLong and Anna Dahl will get some minutes here with a 30-point lead. First foul shot's good for Chisholm, and so is the second. She'll come off, and Jocelyn Moore will come in for her. Cheryl Chisholm had an amazing game. She probably had about 35 points. So she'll sit down for the rest of the game with 2 minutes left. Fowler bringing the ball up the floor. Turns it over. Loose ball on the floor. Great hustle there by X-Woman. Regain that possession. Over to Moore. Up top to DeLong, who swings it over for Dahl. Swings it back to the top for Moore. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Need to take a shot here pretty soon. Inside for DeLong. Ooh, nice try. Great try. Excellent basketball. 3 seconds left on the shot clock. They're going to have to set a nice screen here for the shooter to get open. I wonder who's going to take it. Probably Anderson here. Yep, Anderson for three. Hit back rim. It's close. Sky bringing the ball up the floor. Pushes it to 13. Tompkins, but mishandles it. So it'll be excellent ball. Both benches here into the game here. So they'll play this game out. Lockhart at the top. Look down. Oh, great pass. Great steal by DeLong. Great pass in by Lockhart. That was a great play. Scott bringing the ball to the floor. Left-handed. She's going to go to the line for two, but only because it's bonus. She was blocked there by Jocelyn Moore. She'll shoot two. First one's good. Second one rolls out, and it'll be X-1 basketball on the baseline. Tori Anderson bring the ball up the floor. Pushes up for Dahl. Across to DeLong and across to Moore. He drives middle and kicks it out for Dahl. Good try. Dahl stepped out of bounds. So it'll be Varsity Reds ball. Number 8 to bring it up the floor. Pushes it up to number 13, Tompkins. Inside for Kaminsky. Kicks it out to Holstein. It drives back middle. Number 14 take it in. But she will be called. Oh. Yep. Kylie DeLong called for a blocking foul. So Melissa Foster will go to the line for two. The last couple minutes of this game have just been straight foul shooting, so that's kind of boring. But it happens in a grinded-out game like this when one team's down by so much. Score here is 98-68 for the X-Women. They have 27 seconds left to try and get the century mark. Both the foul shots are good for Foster. Anderson with the ball at the top. Pushes it up for Dahl. Gets a ball screen from DeLong. Still dribbling around. Moore with the ball at the top. Drives middle. Over to Anderson, who drives baseline. She wants that 100-point mark. Kaminsky steps out of bounds. So excellent ball. 10 seconds left in the game. Tori Anderson to pass it in. Moore driving baseline, and a Dahl driving, I mean, whoa. So that will end this game here. We're so close to 100 points. So close. Yet so far. But the final score here is 98-69 for the X-Women. I believe the player of the game for the X-Women should be Cheryl Chisholm. She had about 35 points. Crazy game. So we'll be back here tomorrow for the senior game, the very last home game for all the seniors, graduating players, anyone who might not come back next year to play basketball. It'll be their last home game. So it's a very important game to everyone involved, especially those girls. So UPI will be here. The game is at 2. And hopefully we will be able to get a second headset so you're not just listening to one person the entire game. But thank you for joining us, and we will see you tomorrow afternoon. Till then, see you.